All right, good morning, everyone. We're going to get started. Merry Christmas. So glad you're able to join us here at church, whether you're joining here, online, at home with your family. We welcome you to Long Island Lions Church. We're so glad you're here to join us as we celebrate the birth of our Lord. So why don't we all rise together as we worship this morning.
Have heard on high, sweetly singing, you're the praise, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains.
So highly exalted.
And I'll never know how much it costs to see my sin upon that cross. And I'll never know how much it costs to see my sin upon that cross.
Lord Jesus, we thank you for bringing us here to worship together. We thank you that we're able to truly sing those words that humbly you came to this earth you created. Light of the world, you stepped down into this darkness. You are our everlasting light, Father. We just celebrate that you're here. We celebrate that you came down to dwell with us. And Lord, we just can't wait for that day that we can just be praising you all the day long. We just worship you today, Father, for who you are, what you're doing in our lives, what you will do in our lives, all that you've done, Father. We just praise you. Thank you. Mercy fills the streets to look upon the one who bled to save me and walk with him for all eternity. There will be a day when all will bow before him. There will be a day when death will be no more. Standing face to face with he who died and rose again. Holy, holy is the doubt and fear. In the end, we'll say that it was worth it when he returns to wipe away our tears. There will be a day when all will bow before him. There will be a day when death will be no more. Standing face to face with he who died and rose.
sit beside heroes of the faith, with one voice, a thousand generations say, worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Come on, He's worthy. And on that day, we join the resurrection. Heroes of the faith, with one voice, a thousand generations, sing, worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Forever He shall reign. So let it be today, we shall be. Join in with the angels and sing, holy, Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia. For the Lord God Almighty reigns. Yes, He does.
darkness, we were waiting without hope, without light. Till from heaven you came running, there was mercy in your eyes. To fulfill the law and prophets, to a virgin came the word. From a throne of endless glory, to a cradle in the dirt. Praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the Spirit, three in one. God of glory, majesty, praise forever to the King of Kings. Reveal the kingdom coming, and to reconcile the lost. To redeem the whole creation, you did not despise the cross. For even in your suffering, you saw to the other side. Knowing this was our salvation, Jesus for our sake you died. Till that stone was moved for good, for the Lamb had conquered death. And the dead rose from their tombs, and the angels stood in awe. For the souls of all who'd come to the Father are restored. And the Church of Christ was born, and the Spirit lit the flame. Now this gospel truth of old shall not kneel, shall not faint. By His blood and in His name, in His freedom I am free. For the love of Jesus Christ, who has resurrected me. Praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the Spirit, three in one. God of glory, majesty, praise forever to the King of Kings. Praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the Spirit, three in one. God of glory, majesty, praise forever to the King of Kings. Praise forever to the King of Kings.
God bless you. We're so glad you can join us for today's worship. A Merry Christmas to all of you. Those of you tuning online, so glad to have you join us as well. A Merry Christmas to you. And so today we're celebrating the birth of Jesus Christ. It's a continuation of what we did yesterday. And by the way, those of you that were here yesterday, I can assure you it was a blessed time, right? And it was a time in which God really gave us a time as a family of believers, and not just as a family of believers, but people coming together just to worship the Lord and adoring Christ, our newborn King, coming together and lighting the candle together at the close of our service. What a precious time it was in the Lord. Amen? And then Pastor Chi gave us a reminder, a strong message to each and every one of us that Christmas is about joy, with an acronym that I still remember. Those of you that were here yesterday, or maybe if you tuned in online, what does joy stand for? Anybody remember what joy stands for? Yes, amen. Jesus offers it to you. J-O-Y. Amen to that. Thank you, Pastor Chi, for that ingenious acronym. So we can now all remember that it is the unspeakable joy of God to know that Christ came and was born into this world, and so that we can have hope in Him. And so it was a blessed time in the Lord. And I just want to continue to encourage you, keep celebrating, keep worshiping, keep declaring your praises unto God, for He alone deserves it all, right? Amen. Amen. So we're going to open up with a word of prayer, and God has given me a message to encourage us all on as we continue on the theme of Christmas. So let's open up with a word of prayer. Father, we come before you to thank you, first and foremost, for Christ Jesus, your Son. Thank you, Lord, for coming. Thank you for being born into this world. God, thank you so much for being our Savior. Lord, you are Savior of the world. And God, if there's anything about Christmas that needs to be known, the true meaning behind Christmas is that Jesus came. And Lord, we today, as we continue to adore you, as we continue to worship you, God, I just pray that your Holy Spirit would come, that your Holy Spirit would minister to your people, Lord, here in person and as well as online. God, would you bring hope? Would you bring peace and joy into our hearts, oh God? Would you allow us to experience the unspeakable joy of the Lord? God, that you would continue, Lord, to watch over us, Lord, during this Christmas season, Lord. I pray that you would challenge us, oh God, to really reflect on the true meaning of Christmas, Lord. I ask, Lord, that you would minister, oh God, using us, Lord, to bring the message of God's love to people around us, Lord. And so, Father, we pray that your Holy Spirit would speak and clearly help us, oh God, to receive your word today. I thank you, Lord, Holy Spirit, for using me to be your instrument, to be your mouthpiece today. I ask for your anointing. I ask for God for you to give me a clarity of mind, God, that I will communicate the very words that you have for your people, God. Let it not be words that come from my own mouth, but by the Spirit of God, directed by your Spirit, and that, God, your people will receive it as you desire for them to receive it. And may that be an encouragement to their lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen, church. Amen, church. And so, Christmas, as we all know, is that time of the year where everyone gets busy, right? We talked about that a little bit yesterday when Pastor Chi mentioned about how we spend so much of our time during this Christmas season to shop for gifts, right? We shop for gifts for our loved ones. We shop for gifts for our family members, our friends, and maybe some of our coworkers if they're good to us, right? We shop and we shop and we shop, and we get really busy doing all of these things, right? How many of you guys did that? Let's be honest. How many of you guys got really busy shopping? Just be honest. Like, I mean, you know, I mean, let's be real here, right? That was me back then, okay? And then, as Pastor Chi mentioned, came the beautiful world of online shopping, right? So you could do all your shopping at the comfort of your home, behind a computer, or whatever device that you use to go on the internet to shop from Amazon or from all the other, you know, there's a lot of places we can shop, right? And so we get busy doing all of these things, and we think that's what Christmas is all about, right? How about this? Did you ever wonder that all the retailers love us when we go shopping? I mean, they love it because this is the time of the year where that people spend so much of their money, hard-earned money, on these gifts that we have for people, right? And so they love it when we spend our money. right? This is a crucial time of the year in which they somehow make some earnings that they missed out on throughout the year, because sometimes, you know, there's a dry season and not many people go shopping, right? And so this is the time when retailers are really loving it. And so Christmas is also a time of the year when people look forward to getting together with their family and their friends. How many of you guys have gotten together with your families over this holiday? Some of you guys have done that already, right? Last night, or maybe tonight, or this afternoon. And some of you guys are going to spend time with your friends, you know, going out, having a good time. And so Christmas is also a time of getting together with the people that we love. And maybe for some people who are not regular churchgoers, Christmas can be a time of the year in which they would attend church services, like Christmas Eve services or Christmas Day services, right? And so this is a time of the year where people who normally don't go to church end up visiting a church because, hey, why not? It's Christmas, right? And so this is when people go to church for something that they love doing, right? And it's just to experience the peace and love of God surrounded by people. And maybe that's why you often hear people say that Christmas is the most wonderful time of the year, right? Everyone's familiar with that slogan. Actually, it's popular because of the song that is sung by Andy Williams, right? And so it's the most wonderful time of the year. Amen. We know how well I sing, right? And so this is the time where people will find that this is the most wonderful time of the year because something about Christmas is so special, right? Now, all these things I've said up to this point, they're wonderful. They're good things that we get to do, right? And this is the things that we get to do during Christmas season. We don't necessarily do all of these things throughout the year, but we make time for this during Christmas season. And so, but I have to tell you this, right? This is what I have to say to you. Void of Christ being the real reason why we celebrate Christmas, it would just be another holiday for us. It would just be another holiday that we celebrate like other holidays that we celebrate, right? Void of Christ, it'll just be another holiday. But I got news for you guys. Christmas isn't another holiday. Christmas is not another holiday. Neither is it the time of the year where we go shopping for gifts, even though that's what we do. But that's not really what Christmas is all about. Saints of God, Christmas is about Christ being born. It's about God becoming man. It's about God incarnate, right? The fancy word that we use to describe that God taking on humanity made in the flesh in the person of Jesus Christ. And then this is when you ask, why is that even important? Well, let me tell you something. This is extremely important. This is extremely important. Okay, one worship leader from Rock City Worship puts it this way. This is what she said. The most holy God putting on human form so that by becoming one of us, he might save all of us who believe. You guys get that? The most holy God putting on human form so that becoming one of us, which is us as a human being, he might save us who believe. Amen to that. And so when we think about Christmas, this is the reason. This is the reason why we celebrate Christmas. And I know you know that. I know you've been told this. But you have to understand that Christmas is also about an ancient prophecy that has been fulfilled, which God made a promise to the Israelites in Christ has been fulfilled. Let me read to you a well-known passage that we always read during the Christmas time. And it's taken from Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. It was read even last night. I want to read it to you from the King James Version. This is what it says. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so with this one verse, we can preach many messages about, but that's not what I'm going to do today. I'm going to continue on this understanding of Christmas by focusing on Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is our Savior. Christmas is about Christ being our Savior, being born, God becoming man. It's about God coming down to be with us. Christmas is when love came down. Christmas is about love coming down from heaven, making his home in humankind, to all mankind, so that we can experience God's love, God's hope, God's joy, and God's peace, all lumped together. This is the real reason for our celebration. This is the real reason for our celebration. And let me tell you something, it is far greater than every other reason that we might have for celebrating Christmas. Not that they're all bad. I'm just saying to you that what I just shared with you is far greater than every other reason that we can come up for celebrating during Christmas time. Everything else cannot even compare to the reason for Christmas. Love came down is the true meaning behind Christmas. Love came down is the true meaning behind Christmas. At the heart of Christmas is Jesus as God becoming man. It's God's great gift for you and me. God's great gift. God's greatest gift, I would say. And how do we know this? Because we find this in the scripture. In the scripture, we find that God's greatest gift is found in Jesus Christ. Let's take a look at a well-known verse that we all know, right? John 3:16. Let me read that to you from the NIV version. And we know that for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. And now, when I think about this verse, right, I'm thinking about the sacrifice of Jesus on the cross. That's well known. That's the image that we get. But let's read this again. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, right? It's just God coming down from heaven and loving on us. Love came down. You see, it's not just the cross, but it's God's love that initiates his sacrifice. And so we want to remember that John 3:16 is also the meaning behind Christmas, right? How do we know this? Well, because God has demonstrated his love to us by sending Jesus, his one and only son, to be born in this world. Now, God humbly came down from heaven. God himself humbly came down to heaven, took on human form. I don't know about you, but that is just mind-blowing. The creator of the universe decides to come and be with human beings. Awesome. Awesome to think about. Someone once said, love is a gift our world desperately needs this Christmas season. Love is a gift that our world desperately needs. Can I get an amen for that? Doesn't the world need love? And it's a desperate need for people. Because you know why? Let's think about this for a minute. I mean, think of all the people that you know that are struggling right now. Think about them for a moment. Those who are suffering right now, think about those for a moment. Or those who are experiencing loss, who have experienced loss, right? Think about them for a moment. Or those who are going through a lot of grief because so much is happening in their lives and there's turmoil, everything that's happening, right? Those who feel lost at this moment in life, who are not experiencing hope. And let me tell you something, where a person does not have the experience of hope, there is not much that they want to live for. And so think about these people for a moment and think about love. Think about love being the gift that our world desperately needs during this Christmas season. All right? What better gift can we give to these people? What better gift can we give to these people during this Christmas season than for us to share Christ's love with them? Can you think of a better gift that you can offer to any person in this world than the love of God by telling them that love came down at Christmas so that we can know that through Jesus Christ, God's greatest gift, love gift, I should say, to us, we can have hope, joy, peace, not just for Christmas or during Christmas season, but every day of our lives. Think about that, my brothers and sisters. You need to understand that love came down so that we can experience all of these things. Void of Christ, it would just be another holiday. I want to encourage you all, and those of you tuning in online, I want to encourage all of you to make this Christmas season all about Jesus. Make this season all about Jesus. Let Christ be the center of all. Let Christ be the center of it all. Let our conversations and be seasoned with the love of God. When we get together with our families, when we get together with our loved ones and our friends during this time, we should be sharing Christ's love with them. We should be telling them that love came down. Jesus is our hope. There's no greater gift. There's no greater gift. And there's no greater hope and there's no greater love than what we have in Jesus Christ. You see, Christ being born changed the course of history forever. I just told my mother-in-law this morning, who's not a believer, I said to her, you know what? Christmas would just not even exist if it wasn't for the birth of Jesus Christ. And even though she doesn't know the Lord, she kind of agreed with me. Yeah, you're right. Right? And so without Christ, there's no Christmas. Now, I wish all that I shared with you today, I wish that I had known this as a teenager when I was struggling in rebellion, living a life that is so fallen. I wish I knew these things about Christmas. I was struggling with identity. I was trying so hard to find meaning and purpose in life. But while I was trying to find meaning and purpose in life, I was looking for it in all the wrong places. All the wrong places. And you can imagine where that might be. I looked in friendship. I looked in relationships. I looked in material possession. All of these things wouldn't compare to Christ. When all along, our true identity, our meaning, and our purpose in life can only be found in Jesus Christ alone. I do remember when I was in high school, there was a person who tried to reach out to me during the times that I felt like everything was going well for me. This wasn't during my, you know, days where I was really seriously depressed, right? This was a time when everything was going well. She tried to share with me the love of Christ. She tried every single week that we had class together. And for some reason, I don't know what it was, I was so blinded by the world. I couldn't hear a single word that she was saying. I couldn't receive this message. I couldn't hear. I couldn't accept it. But saints of God, I want to encourage you to proclaim God's greatest love gift to us, to every single person that you will be spending your Christmas time during this season with. Every single person that you can think of that you will be spending time with, I encourage you to proclaim God's greatest love gift to us. And I'm praying for all of us here and those of you joining online, I'm praying that we would be so filled with God's love, with God's hope, and with God's peace, and with God's joy during this Christmas season that we cannot help but to share with them the love of Christ. That it would be spilling over from our own lives into the lives of other people. Think about how we can do that during this Christmas season, because the main reason why we celebrate is because of Christ. Love came down at Christmas. Let me end with just a few encouraging words, which I find so, so encouraging. It's a quote from a worship leader from Rock City Worship. This is what I want to share with you as a closing thought. This Christmas season, we remember God's promises to his people remain the same. That in our brokenness and sin, God steps in and offers us hope in himself. That even in the darkest of times, in Jesus, we have hope. We have joy. We have peace. And we have the light of salvation. Our hope is sure. Amen. Our hope will last. Amen. Our hope has a name. Amen. And his name is Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us. Amen, church. Amen. Let's have this hope in our hearts. Let's carry this hope to every person that we will be spending time with. I'm telling you, people are in need of God's love. We have it. We want to proclaim it, and we want to center this message on Jesus Christ and him alone being born into this world so that we can have all of these things that we just talked about. Amen, church. Let me close in prayer as the worship team comes and closes us out in the song. Let's pray. Father, I thank you so much. Thank you so much that, Lord, your word encourages us, Lord, to know and to remember that the real reason why we celebrate Christmas isn't just the gatherings, isn't about the gifts swapping. It isn't about the shopping, Lord. It's all about Jesus, oh God. It's all about God coming down to earth. Love came down at Christmas, and we are the recipients of this love gift from Jesus, from God himself. Lord, I just pray, God, that you would encourage us during this time. God, whatever we do, Lord, I pray that we would not be busy going about one place to another. Lord, spending time with people is so important. But I pray, God, I pray that you would allow us to spend time in such a way where we will share and proclaim the real reason why we celebrate during this season. That Christmas is about love coming down. Lord, I ask, God, that you would encourage our hearts when we gather with our families, our friends, our loved ones, Lord, whoever that we might be spending time, I pray, God, that they would sense God's love in a powerful way, God, that you would draw them into a relationship with you, God. There are many people that are struggling right now in the Christmas season, Lord. There are many people who are suffering and struggling and feeling hopeless, feeling lost, feeling abandoned, oh God. But God, help us be the people to bear the message of hope, the message of love, the message of peace, and the message of joy, and that you are the light of salvation, oh God. Oh God, fill us with your Holy Spirit. Allow us, oh God, to speak every word from you that we might be able to encourage someone right now during this time when it's really hard for many people, God. And Father, Lord, I just pray that you will bless every single person here today. Bless those that are tuning in online. I pray for a special blessing from you, God, that they would sense your great love, your joy, your peace, and your hope throughout this time. We love you, oh God. We thank you. We pray this all in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Peter, for the message. Why don't we all rise to close out this service.
Christ, the Lord.
this happy morning, Jesus, to thee be all glory.